Very good afternoon, all of you. Myself, Dr. Kamini Solanki, and I'm representing the practical approach for the fingerprint recognitions by combining the local binary patterns and principal component analysis. Right, so this is my title. Okay, let's discuss about now. Fingerprint is nowadays, fingerprint is used for the real-time applications nowadays. So it is because it is more reliable, right? So and you said that fingerprints gives the rapid result, fastest result. So we can use the fingerprints for the real-time applications. So that's why here in proposed systems, we have used the fingerprints for the recognitions of the persons, whether that person, what is the ID of that person, right? So fingerprint is used for the real-time applications. In our proposed system, we have used two algorithms, local binary patterns and principal component analysis. So local binary pattern, and both are used, both have some drawback and both have some of the features. So here we combine the features of LBP and PCA, and try to increase the recognition rate of fingerprints. Now let us discuss about the LBP and PCA. LBP means what? It's a local binary patterns, right? So sometimes in our finger, we have some local features, right? And PCA means what? Principal component analysis. So it considers the global features. So here we combine the local feature plus global features. Right, so we can recognize the particular person and accurate result, right? So we can increase the recognition rate, right? And we can decrease the false match rate. Now, false match rate means what? False match rate means, suppose I am giving my fingerprints, and instead of Dr. Kamini Solanki, it shows the presence of, for example, Abhishek Mehta. So actual finger is belongs to finger is from Dr. Kamini Solanki, but instead of that person, it shows some another's name, right? That is false match rate. It will match, but falsely it will match, means it gives the incorrect result to the from the system to the person, right? So here we have used in proposed system, we have used LBP and PCA. LBP means local binary pattern and PCA means principal component analysis. So
Dr. Kamini, sorry to interrupt you. Can you give certain examples of your LBP and PCA? Because we have many students here also, yeah, who want to know. Yeah.
I will, sir. I will. In my presentations, I have. Okay. So in fingerprints recognitions, you can use like this here. Listen, fingerprints have local features and global features. So in local features, two methods are most popular, local binary patterns and Gabor method. In global features, we have LDA, linear discriminant analysis, and PCA, principal component analysis. So here we combine the LBP and PCA. LBP for the local features and PCA means global features. Local features means what? Here, suppose in our finger, we have some marks, some dots, or some identity which can identify that person, particular persons. And global feature means what? The shape of that finger, right? Because you know that each and every, even the twins, but twins have the different fingerprints. So the shape of the fingers means edges, and the local features, both are different. So here we have a combination of both local and global, right? And here we have used the 300 to 350 DPI range, means dots per each images for the experiment. Okay, so here you all are aware with the fingerprints, arc, loop, and hole. All types of fingerprints are there, right? These are the different representations of fingerprints. There are different features are available. So we extract the features. Now, local features and global features. Sometimes in your finger, we have some local features, and global means the shape. And local means the some identifications of that particular local features, right? Suppose here I have, for the local, I have used the LBP. Now, what is LBP? LBP, why we have used LBP? Because first reason, LBP is the fastest, right? And it gives the accurate result. Listen, LBP means what? Suppose, in short, it's an image. When we take the when we give the fingerprints, it is in the form of image. An image in the form of row and column means each pixel have some values, right? So it is in the form of matrix. So each and every pixel have some value, right? So for example, this is the local value of your images, means this is the pixel value. For example, this is the pixel value. Here, point, just a point to be noted, here we need to convert our RGB value into the grayscale, right? So RGB, it is divided by 3. Your R value, G value, and B, RGB value divided by 3. So it becomes the average. So your average is considered as a gray value, grayscale. And grayscale have a single value, right? Because we cannot process on 3 values, RGB. So instead of processing on 3 values, we are processing only a single values, and that is the gray value. Grayscale value means it is the average. It is the average of RGB. Right. So for example, this is the value of your finger. Right. 5, 4, 3. Right. 4, 3, 1, and 2, 0, 3. So here you have to minus from the center value. So 5 minus 3. 4 minus 3, 3 minus 3, 1 minus 3. You know, your neighbor values are deducted from your center value, right? If it is positive, put 1. If it is negative, put 0, right? 5 minus 3, 1. 4 minus 3, positive, 1. 3 minus 3, 1, positive, right? 1 minus 3, your neighbor value are deducted from your center value. 1 minus 3 means it's a negative. So if your value is negative, then put it 0, right? So we have one binary values for local features. So yahan pe suppose meri har ek pixel ki values aati hai. So for these values, I have some binary values for that particular local area. So in this particular local area, I have binary values of 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. And that value is converted into the decimal value. Suppose these portions of my finger have value 233. Hello?
Dr. Solanki?
Ha, yes, yes.
So can you again explain how you are getting the value 5, 4, 3? And 4, 3,
it's an example. Paper? It's an example, sir. Here, this is whatever value you have given. Right, it's a pixel value. Suppose pixel first value you have the... RGB. Suppose yeah. Yahan pe RGB hai. Suppose 10 plus G ki value 20 plus 3 ki value 30. So 10 plus 20 plus 30. Then it's a.
No, I want to understand whether when we are having a fingerprint impression. Mm-hmm. Let's say when we are having a fingerprint impression, how yes. we are getting the value 5, 4, 3 on what basis?
On what basis? Suppose yeah. you have given an image. Right, you are indirectly that image is what it's a matrix. It's a matrix. Your image is a matrix. Row and column. Each row and column have some pixel. Pixel have some value, RGB value. Your RGB value is converted into grayscale. Right, we cannot
the process. Pixel, the- but the pixel depends upon the. The pixel depends upon the DPI or the resolution in which we have scanned the fingerprint. Then these values must vary at that time.
So that's why we are converting into the RGB.
Okay.
Grayscale, sorry. So RGB value must be converted into grayscale, because grayscale have only single value, but RGB have 3 values, R, G, and B. So okay, we cannot you. Process on three values. We are processing one single value. So we are converting our color image into the grayscale image. So grayscale, converting the grayscale image, that is mandatory in this algorithm, right? For the accurate result. So suppose this is the value, for example, value of your this particular cell is 5. For example, second cell value is 4, third cell value is 3, right? So you have one matrix. Particular matrix of your finger. For example, this is the matrix of your finger. Your RGB value that is converted into the grayscale value, and that is, for example, this is the value. So this base, if your value is this, then your neighbor value is deducted from the center value. So 5 minus 3, if it is positive, then 1. If it is negative, then 0. So then you have some binary values, right? 1110001. Okay, then your system will convert your binary value into decimal value. Okay, so particular for that particular gray, I have filled up the gray color. So for that particular cell, your decimal value is 233. So when you compare your image with the database image at that time, on that particular cell value is nearby 233, you can fetch that images. Okay, that image is matched with this three or four images because the value of that particular local features are nearby with that particular fingers from the database. Okay, now PCA algorithm. In PCA algorithm, that is used for the feature extraction. You might be aware with the eigenvalues and eigenmatrix. So, in our MATLAB, we have a ready-made functions for each and everything. So first you need to convert your color image into the grayscale image. Then after the grayscale image, you can find out the mean of particular row or column, right? So you can find the value of particular, you can find the mean of that particular row or particular column. Then you have to apply the one function is their eigenvector. Eigenvector is used to find the features of that particular images, right? So this is a ready-made function. So we have to calculate, and there is the formula of eigenvectors. So from that formula, we need to calculate the eigenvector and eigenvalue, okay? So here you can see that we have already implemented, okay, PC algorithms. So in this, first you need to find the average value, then you have to color into grayscale, then average value, then find the sigma lambda value, means eigenvector and eigenvalue, and then you have to calculate the features, okay? And so this is the, we have implemented through the code in MATLAB PC algorithm. Why we have used PCA and LBP? PCA have highest recognition rate, right? So we have referred to so many research paper and we have implemented this algorithm. So based on the readings, we have find that if PCA have the highest recognition rate, and it will work on the global feature, global shape of your face, where LBP algorithm is the fastest execution time LVP have, and it is more suitable for the real-time applications, and it will also remove the illumination problem. Suppose your image have background noise, right? So LVP can also work because it works on the local features. So LVP can easily works on the local features. So it will illuminate the problem, illumination problem, right? And it can fetch the local features. So that's why we have, in proposed method, we have combined both LBP and PCA. So this is our proposed method. So we find the image, okay, then in that image we convert the grayscale, then apply the LBP algorithm, then PCA algorithm means calculate the eigenvector and eigenvalue, right? And then we store that image into the database, right? And when suppose our image is stored into the database, now I'm applying my images for the attendance or for presence. So at that time, again, it will follow the same algorithm and it will calculate the local value, means local decimal value, and through the LBP, and it will consider the shape, right? And then it will match with the database images, okay? And then it will fetch that out of 100, 500, 1000, right, 1500 images, it will find the best match of that particular image. Okay, so we have implemented our proposed algorithm. So LBP, PCA, and hybrid algorithm. So this is the readings of our proposed algorithm and existing algorithm, right? So here, suppose database image have 5. So in database, we have stored 5 images, and those images which are not in database, that images we are given as an input. So 6 images, different images we have given as an input, right? So in database, we have stored 5 images and 6 different images we have given as an input. So PC algorithm have this much accuracy rate, 76, 63, and 58, right? If you are, if you increase, subject means the fingerprints, right? So if you increase the person, at that time, PCA have decreased the performance, as well as LBP has also decreased the performance, right? And false match rate means, you know, it gives the false result, right? It gives the false result. It is the fingerprint of Kamini Solanki, but instead of, it shows the presence of Abhishek Mehta, right? So that is false match rate. So it, you can see that the false match rate will increase, means it gives the false result, increase the false result. But in our proposed method, you can see that we have increased the result, right? So we can say that if you want to increase the, you know, results of IBP and PCA, sorry, if you want to increase the results of fingerprints, you can use this method, proposed method, LBP and PCA, and that will give the accurate results compared to the existing system. And these are the references. Thank you.